everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I have a Christmas themed cage setup for you all. I'm super excited to be filming this and I'm going to be showing each component of this cage and why I have it the way that it is, and I hope you enjoy it. Let's just get right into it. Okay, so this is the Double Ferret Nation, which you've seen in my last cage tour video. It's the same exact cage. It might be set up a little differently as far as like the platforms. I don't exactly remember what I had it as in my last one that I made. First off, this is where we have the cage in my room. It's right next to the bed. It's a pretty massive cage. It takes up a lot of space. Now, my ferrets are free-roamed ferrets. They are not ever locked in this cage unless both Brian and I are gone for an extended period of time. They are never usually locked in here. That's why this door has been taken off so that they can easily climb onto this. We have this little cube here. It's so that they can jump up and off of the bed with ease. They don't have to jump from a very high distance and possibly get hurt. So that's why I have that. But this is the lowest level of the cage. Down here is a little storage compartment, and that's where I keep the ferret first aid kit. That way it's easy for me to pull out in case of an emergency. And we have a mat here so that this will not slide around, because it does slide around. And most of the cage accessories, which I'll go through them all one by one, is by Pets Galore Studio. I will put her in the description of this video. She is my friend and she creates accessories for ferrets and other animals. Now, she made these ladder covers, which are super pretty, out of nice, high quality fleece material. And this is an actual liner as well. This is my first time actually getting real liners. I usually just line the cage with baby blankets, but this is much better because they can't actually slide around. They are completely covered so the ferrets can't mess with them. I have a little ornament here because my ferrets are not naughty to the point where they would knock them down, but normal ferrets would probably want to mess with that, but mine are pretty nice about it. I have their most favorite item ever, and it's this gray cat bed that can collapse into an actual bed from the cube setting, but they love it this way. It is their most favorite thing. I don't even know how many ferrets. I think it's just Appa in there right now, but they just love this cube. They'll sleep in it over anything else if I have it in there. And I'm not worried about disturbing him because he is deaf, so he can't even hear me talking, but I have like a little pillow in here, and it's lined with, I don't even remember, I think it was my travel soft cage that I had, soft crate. It came with like a little fuzzy liner thing, and that's what that is. But I did get this cube from a drugstore. I believe that this was in my last video. I'm still using it. It's still held up. It's kind of annoying because the material in here is kind of like flipped, kind of got a little messed up, so it doesn't stand up as nice as it used to, but it's still usable. And here I have just a normal cat bed, and I've actually used one of the platform liners that was sent to me by Pets Galore Studio as a sort of cover for it. And I have another ladder up here. The nice thing about these platforms for this cage is they have multiple levels that you can do. You can put it lower. I think this is the highest that you can have it. Now, I put it up super high so that this would fit underneath it. So I have this ladder here so that they don't have to jump from such a far distance, and this bed kind of sort of cushions their fall. Usually you would put like a ladder here that's to go to the upper level, but they don't really need it. They're very agile young ferrets, so they can climb up through that hole and they can also jump down. And I have a hammock here that I got off of Amazon. I think this was in my last one as well. I just recently put it back in. The ferrets do not honestly use this like at all. It's just something that I have in here because I have it. They don't actually really like to use this. So I have another one of the liners that goes over this platform here, and they absolutely love these liners. They'll actually sleep just right up on here on top of the liner, instead of, you know, sleeping in a bed. Then we move to the top level. So here we have a clip-on croc. That's what that looks like for their water. And then I keep their meals in ceramic bowls. I like to feed them at the top level of the cage because it minimizes the amount of stashing that they do. So I have a gray hard plastic sort of like meal bowl holder, whatever you want to call it, placemat for that, so that they don't get the liners all dirty with their meat when they take it out. Because a lot of the time they'll actually pick out the meat and then like eat it right here, right next to the bowl. They won't actually eat in the bowl, which is a little frustrating, but it's whatever. And we have a red crinkle mat to go with the theme of Christmas, because there's another red component in here as well, which I will get to. It is a crinkle mat. It's really, I don't know, I don't really like it that much. It has like a permanent crease in it, so that's why I have this ladder holding it in place. We have a little Totoro, which I don't actually usually keep in here, but they don't mess with it, so I just thought it was a cute little addition to this cage. I have two other little ornaments and the Christmas lights that line the cage as well. So this cube, which I was super excited to receive, was by Pets Galore Studio. It has a red inside, and then it also has like a little mat in there. And this cube is super, super high quality. It stays up pretty much on its own. It's very firm and sturdy. Patsu really likes to use it to stash his toys. That's what he mainly uses it for. And here we have a little blanket that she made me, and a normal gray cat bed. This is the flat bed. They really like the flat ones over like the ones with the sides, like the one down there. And then one of their most favorite things is actually my gray infinity scarf. They love to cuddle in this, so I figured, you know, whatever, I don't care if it smells like ferret, so I just keep it in there for them. They love it there, so I just keep it. And on the top here is where I keep all of their extra bedding. I have all of their baby blankets, towels, extra hammocks, pillowcase covers, which I use to cover the beds, and pee pads. So that is what I have there for the cage, but that is pretty much it. And that is the end of my Christmas cage setup tour. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. A little bit of a short video today. I know I've been super busy working nearly every single day. I also have like 7 students in my new mentoring program for raw feeders, and it's been going super well. I should be able to accept new students within the coming weeks. I'm not exactly sure yet. Everyone is at their own pace with it, so I really don't know when certain people are going to be finishing and when I can start opening spots up again. But I'm super happy that you guys have been enjoying the course and have been super interested in it. I already have like a wait list, I guess you could say, for new students in the new course, so that is also really exciting for me. I'm super happy that I decided to take the jump to do the course, because I really needed something to get me motivated and keep me busy, really, alongside my actual job, because that can be really draining if you're only doing like one thing at a time. So I like to do many things that I really love doing. So I will see you guys in my next video. Do not forget to follow me on Instagram, because that's where I post my pretty raw meal pics and just pictures of the ferrets in general. So follow me on that. Also, I have a Discord server now, which I'm active on, and so is many other people who own ferrets there. We can answer your questions. You could just, you know, make some new friends. It's just a really nice space for like-minded people to hang out. So check that out as well if you have Discord. And that is pretty much it. So I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!